I hustle, trap. Bust a record, get two back, and the tub will go. Call me two pack. I'm a nut, use a blue sack. You had your chance, but you blew that. H2, two seizures. H8, ADHD. Uh-huh. Somewhere along the road came asthma. B2 out of three, it ain't faze me. For those who think I had it safely, you hella mistake. Hey, you guys. So we're back today. I'm back today with another video. All right. So this video is going to be discussing Stephanie Hamill. These damn conservatives. Oh my God. It's so annoying. These conservatives, ever since Cardi B and the whole situation with Trump, these conservatives tried anything left and right to blame Cardi B. You know what I'm saying? Even for a song that she's featured on. Now, don't get me wrong. She's still a participant in it, but she's a fucking feature. But nonetheless, it is Cardi B. She's from the strip club. I don't understand why y'all expecting or waiting to watch Cardi B walk through, you know what I'm saying, dressed like the Pope with a Bible. And then if she did, then she would get ripped apart then. So it's this girl can't win for losing. But nonetheless, for those of y'all who don't know, Cardi B made a video about Trump. If you've been living under a rock, because that's the only way you couldn't have seen it by now. She made a video about Trump and how, you know what I'm saying, there are 800,000 plus people that are going to work for free. They're not getting paid. Their bills are not getting paid. And these tenants, they don't give a shit about that. So they're ending up homeless, you know what I'm saying? And a lot of people, you know what I'm saying, black people included, which I was like, you know, Graham, I know the girl only Afro-Latin. And even if you don't think that, agree with the whole she's Afro-Latin, she's a minority nonetheless. Like, we could do better with our own, but we could also do better with minorities too. Because at the end of the day, once white people, you know, in their head, this is how supremacy works and all that shit. Once they obliterate the image of black people and get rid of us, next it is Latinos. And next it is, you know, Puerto Ricans and all that through. So, I mean, through and through, everybody, you know what I'm saying, they don't like none of us motherfuckers at the end of the day. People who have that, you know, supremacist mindset, that racist mindset, that colorist mindset, they don't like none of us. You know what I'm saying? So no one is better off than the other. You know what I'm saying? Is she problematic? Yes. But at the end of the day, you don't need a degree in journalism or, you know what I'm saying, anything in politics to have sympathy or empathy for people who are homeless, who don't have their jobs, who are working for free. You don't need all you need is sympathy and empathy for that. You don't need a degree for that. You know what I'm saying? I get so tired of stuck up ass people like that. But nonetheless, so she said that ever since then, Tommy Loren came out. Y'all already know I told y'all in the last video, I ain't talking about this bitch. It's very obvious that ain't nobody ever punched Tommy Loren in her fucking face. That's how I feel about her and people like her, because there are black people just like her. There are Asian people just like, there's people all around the world like her. And I say the same thing to all of them. And I would say it to their face if I seen them. I would look at them and say, looks like you've never been punched in your face before in life. And walk off. All right. So with that being said, now it's Stephanie Hamill's turn. So she tweets, in the era of hashtag Me Too, how exactly does this empower women? Leftists at Cardi B, feel free to chime in. Thanks. And she's talking about the Twerk video. All right. So Cardi B, I only got one of her screenshots. I think I want to say Wale also came to the defense too. So with that being her defense, Cardi B's defense, she's had one tweet and I didn't get that one. But the other one says, it says to women that I can wear and not wear whatever I want, do whatever I want, and that no still means no. Ooh, excuse me. So Stephanie, chime in. If I twerk and be half naked, does that mean I deserve to get raped and molested? I want to know what a conservative woman likes you think. Let me tell y'all something. I see a lot of people talking shit, saying that Cardi B ain't typing these tweets, writing them. I don't give a shit. They're funny nonetheless. I really don't. You know what I'm saying? I don't think she's stupid. Politics is one of the things that, you know what I'm saying, history and stuff, that is stuff that interests her. You know what I'm saying? We need to get out of that open, that box that we have, that condition we have of trying to box people in. You know what I'm saying? For people who love to raise their kids and say don't judge people, a lot of y'all adults is judgy as hell. You know what I'm saying? I'm just saying. But nonetheless, so, Wale then comes to her defense and says, this makes no sense. Just say you're jealous that you incapable of such coordination and rhythm, and kindly leave the podium. Thanks. So she says, LOL, you're right. I definitely don't know how to twerk. So she mad she ain't got flued out. That's what it was. She ain't get flued out. She ain't get flued out. All right, let me relax. Ooh, that soju is good. I'm just saying. 21 has its perks. So with that being said, he responds and he says, so maybe, .. let them have fun, ? Find something you know about. Mind the business that pays you, with all due respect. He did say with all due respect. It was better than I would have said. I would have left that last part off. I liked everything else. Then he also, he's responded to somebody who says, the future of our young black girls is totally destroyed. As much as I love the beautiful shape, it's sad that black women have reduced themselves to an ass, and that's pretty much what we look at. We as people are look like as a people, us black men included. All right, okay, I was going to call him bullshit on that, because one thing I don't like about this twerk video is that men are being one-sided. You know what I'm saying? When a black woman shows off the ass and does the ass music videos, it's a problem. But they don't want to acknowledge Juvenile, back that ass up. You know what I'm saying? Any Young Money video, you know what I'm saying? 2 Chainz video, any video that got ass that a black man does, and there's vixens and whatever, they never want to, niggas never want to acknowledge that. You know what I'm saying? They don't want to ever pull their own brethren to the forefront, their own black man to the forefront. I don't like that shit. You know what I'm saying? But when it's a female, it's all hell, and this is why black girls is fast nowadays, all this other shit. So nonetheless, so he names Lena Waithe, Issa Rae. Hey, Issa Rae, I'ma see your movie. I'ma see it. Taraji, I might see your movie. I gotta see what she said about R. Kelly, because some people, you know, I don't know if people in their feelings or whatever, or if they just took it the wrong way. Maya Moore, Simone Biles, Robin Fenty. I can go on for days. Not Robin Fenty, not the government. I can go on for days. You control what you watch for inspiration. That is true. I do want to say that. Like, I'm one of those people, if I don't like it, I just don't watch it. I don't tune into it. So I don't understand people who have to go on these long rants and stuff. Just don't watch the shit. But nonetheless, and he says confidence, and he looks up, he types in the word empowerment. And it says authority or power given to someone to do something. The process of becoming stronger and more confident, especially in controlling one's life and claiming rights. So at the end of the day, the video is empowering. It's empowering to them, the people who did the video. You know, I'm twerking, I'm doing me, and I don't care what nobody says. At the end of the day, if that's not the type of empowerment that you want, that's fine. But you're not right to say that's not empowering, or this person can't do that, or da da da. Stop trying to police people with their bodies, you know what I'm saying, at the end of the day. You know what I'm saying? Now, as for the whole, I kind of see where people are coming from with the whole, you know what I'm saying, it gives black women a bad look, you know what I'm saying? And a lot of people, you know, like one of these new YouTubers I'm getting into, D Mademoiselle, I like her. I just told my neighbor about her because they're both Haitian. And I was like, I think you would like her. But she's talking about the twerk video, and she's like, while she does like the video, it is kind of sad that, you know what I'm saying, that's all, you know, for the majority, all the videos, dark-skinned girls. You know what I'm saying? When she had one white bitch in her feelings. What's her name? Leanne or something. Whatever the fuck. Her name starts with an L. And while I will say, she's not the shittiest twerker in the world. You know what I'm saying? She has a video where she's twerking it or whatever. But she talks about there being no white girls. You know white people always got to be. She's just a pick me. You know what I'm saying? White people always trying to be invited to shit. Bitch, you're not in every cultural circle. That's like a black person getting mad that they're not invited to a country music set. Or they're not having a dark-skinned black girl host Blake Shelton or whoever fuck country artist, not having a dark-skinned black woman in their music video. Which, you know, if they did, oh, we would hear about it. Oh, we would hear about it. You know what I'm saying? That's the thing. They never want to acknowledge the flip side of shit. And then on top of that, there is a white girl in the short video. There's like one or two. It's not something that y'all can really do. You know what I'm saying? I'm just keeping it honest. You know what I'm saying? And then you got a lot of black men gassing up y'all heads like y'all snow bunnies. No, bitch, that's a polar bear. Okay, let me relax because this soju is good. Woo! Nonetheless, I see where people is coming from with that. You know, oh yeah, no, my bad, going back. So she said dark skin, you know, it's sad that, you know what I'm saying, we don't have a lot of videos with a whole row of dark skinned women. And in this video, it's nice that that representation is there, but they're twerking. You know what I'm saying? We need a balance. And I do agree with that. I do agree with that. Like, I know when I start getting into my music and doing love dove song, lovey-dovey songs and shit, my, you know, when I go to cast for the women, they will be, in particular, the darker skins, the Dreezies, the Castrols, you know what I'm saying? And I'm not even saying having that type of body. I'm just saying skin tone alone, because I do feel like, you know what I'm saying, I have to do my part in my community to make it better. And colorism is just as bad as racism. You know what I'm saying? It's just as alive. You know what I'm saying? You got high schoolers out here doing fucking videos talking about some light skin or dark skin. Bitch, sit your ass down somewhere. Read a fucking book. Oh my god. Brothers. Nonetheless. So, at any rate, I'm going back to what I was saying though. So, I know that, you know what I'm saying, that's important. However, to them, it's empowering. You know what I'm saying? That's the, and you can't, if so, empowering is one taking over their life and, you know, basically saying, I'm going to do what I want to do. You really can't judge that, even by the definition. Like, it doesn't, it's one person, it's one person's business and one person's business only. They wanted the best twerker, they found her. The girl in the end, she ended up getting paid for $25,000. And even if they didn't get paid, I'm pretty sure they still got paid to be in the video, if I'm not mistaken. You know what I'm saying? I'm sure they weren't just twerking their ass off for free. They all had their reasons for doing it. You know what I'm saying? But I can acknowledge the other side too and say that we do need more positive representation in the media and in music with our dark-skinned women. But it starts with us. That starts with us. I do believe that. Because that's the problem in our community alone. I understand white people did. You know what I'm saying? I understand the whole, you know, field niggas and house niggas. I understand that concept. But now it's on us. We're not slaves anymore. You know what I'm saying? There are rappers with plenty of money. These rappers have choices in casting who they want to cast. So y'all continue to cast these little white bitches. These are these Italian bitches, you know what I'm saying? White bitches. But nonetheless, you know what I'm saying? These Hispanic girls, y'all continue to wife up them and this, that, and the other, you know what I'm saying? But hide with your, you know, claim race, you know, pro-black. You know what I'm saying? That doesn't work. It doesn't work. It doesn't make sense. You know what I'm saying? I just, and that's not to say that not every, you know what I'm saying, video, like, the. That's not to say that's not all that not all of them is doing it. And I'm also not saying you can't go back to the 2000s and find a video where there is a dark-skinned love interest girl. But I'm saying it's very rare, you know what I'm saying, in conjunction with the opposite. You know what I'm saying? Light-skinned girls, you know what I'm saying? So it's something that we need to work on in our community all together. You know what I'm saying? And also understanding that just because one has a preference, that for one, we don't need to hear it. We don't need to know your preference. And for two, a preference is not, let me uplift this one and put that one down. That's you being an asshole. So we also need to understand that. I think those are things that would help in our community. Stop telling everybody what you date. We'll see. I follow the Shade Room. I see TMZ from time to time. We will see who you date. You know, we don't need you to tell us that fuck a black bitch, you want a red bone. We don't need to hear that. So there are things that we can do in our community alone to help this. And I say black men because, keep it real, I haven't seen a video like Twerk since Anaconda by Nicki Minaj. I'm not comparing the two because I know Cardi B and Nicki got their little thing or whatever. So I'm not comparing the two. I'm just saying the last time I seen a girl, you know, use, you know, sexual empowerment, let's call it that, you know what I'm saying, in a video like that, to that monumental status, and it got that much notoriety, it was Anaconda. Hell, that was her number two record, if I'm not mistaken. She ain't never had a number one, but you know what I'm saying, let me relax. But that was her number, her record that made it number two. So, you know what I'm saying, that's what I'm saying when I say that. But, you know what I'm saying, I'm pretty sure in between that time frame, there might have been a few other girls. You know what I'm saying? But I'm saying records that have made it that monumental. You know what I'm saying? That's why I'm saying that. But I'm sure in between those, there's been plenty of those Chris Brown music videos with naked girls and, you know, ass everywhere, dark-skinned girls, girls of all complexions, you know what I'm saying? And so it's a two-way street, you know what I'm saying? I get where people are coming from, but also, and then here and again, like I say, if I don't like something, I just don't tune into it. Like Wale said, you choose what you're influenced by, and this, that, and the third, you know what I'm saying? If you raise your child in a certain way and facilitate certain things in her, there are children who, they will look at that video and be like, Mom, what are they doing? Mom, that's not da-da-da-da, this, that, and the other. You know what I'm saying? So we also have to take accountability as parents, too. You know what I'm saying? Because if you're facilitating your child not to want to watch a video like Twerk, you know what I'm saying? If your child like classical music, they're going to be like, what the fuck is this? You know what I'm saying? And at the end of the day, you can't control their lives, but I'm saying as a parent, there are things you can facilitate. So I think that's another thing, too, because you can't look at these artists to raise your child. You know what I'm saying? I say that being an artist myself. You know what I'm saying? I am eventually going to get to some point where I start putting out clean versions. I would like to do that. You know what I'm saying? Because I know I do have some youth that looks up to me. But I overall, I'm not here to raise your fucking kid. Like, I mean, I'm not. So, you know what I'm saying? That's another thing, too. You know what I'm saying? Facilitating certain things in your children. And you know what I'm saying? Telling them, this is a music video that centers around this topic. This is not real life, okay? It's not real life. You know what I'm saying? Giving them, you know, that difference between reality and fiction, what's fantasy and what's real in life. You know what I'm saying? So, nonetheless, that's pretty much all my sayings and thoughts on the video. Or in the topic, you know what I'm saying, of people talking about the video being good or bad. You know what I'm saying? I see both points. But at the end of the day, we do need to acknowledge the hypocrisy of black men bringing that up when they do the same shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, black women learn that from y'all. And now they do it. And now it's an issue. That doesn't make any fucking sense. You know what I'm saying? So I think black men do need to take accountability to these rappers. You know what I'm saying? Even the low budget ones, you know, shawty, shake that ass. And she da-da. They'll have no problem getting a dark-skinned girl to shake their ass while they throwing cash on them while they twerking on some motel bed or something. So let me stop. So, you know what I'm saying? We all play our part. You know what I'm saying? And it's about holding each other accountable and being honest. If you fucked up, you fucked up. You know what I'm saying? But y'all let me know what y'all think down below. You know what I'm saying? And then also, I want to say this, too, again. It's not her song. She's just a feature. They could have got anybody. Hell, they're from Miami. They could have gotten Trina to do the song. You know what I'm saying? Would it have still been a problem then? I don't think so. But nonetheless, y'all let me know what y'all think down below. And I will catch y'all on the next video. Peace.